Well, the chicks that were born April 19th are now coming out of their brooder area in the back, and they're exploring what we call the hallway or the vestibule. And we have grass and straw and sandbags that they can find little nooks in. There's more access to weather, like the sun and the wind and the rain, for them to get used to that before we put them in quail tractors in our pasture, which will probably be about tomorrow if we can get them all ready for this season. Some of them are still laying underneath the heat tray in the brooder area. Most of them are out here kind of testing out their wings, exploring new areas. They're all super, super curious about my adult quail. And at this age, they're all feather sexable. So the polka dot chests, like right there, those are my new hens. And then the clear chest or the slightly rosy chest, those are the males. And so this is a really good time to put your breeding birds together, like one male with five or six hens, sometimes eight. It depends on the male. Some are pushy, some aren't. Here's a male right here. You can see his red chest. That's a male right there. But everyone's testing out their wings. There's a male and a female right here. Hi, guys. And the sandbags give them really nice access to little nooks and crannies, which is really cool. There's a little male right there. You can see his red chest. But it's cool. I like to see him out exploring. And they're out here all day now in the vestibule. And then I just put him in the brooder at night. But I think I'm going to start leaving the brooder door open and leaving the heat tray on, only because some of them are flying over the wall and then they're stuck out here all night long by themselves. So this way they can come and go and they can choose the heat or the weather. It's totally up to them. Hi guys, you guys are so cute. Some of them are finding their voices. Hi guys, here's a little male. Some of the males will also stand really tall and start to crow like the adult males. Well, hello. Hello. We've got wing testers. They're all learning how to use their wings. Hi, guys. Okay, time to go do chores. So nice to have lots and lots of happy, healthy quail chicks. My next incubation cycle didn't work as planned. I couldn't get the eggs that I wanted. And so instead of being 3 weeks apart, they'll be more like 6 weeks apart, which actually might work out pretty good. So it always happens like it should. And you can see my adult quail in here, quail house number two. They're totally chill and not really affected by the new ones. And if we decide to keep any hens in here outside of the tractors and incorporate them with our adult quail, it'll be tomorrow. If you don't put new quail in as chicks before they hit sexual maturity,
the adult quail get really hard on them and will actually sometimes kill them. So I always try to get the new ones in there when they're still little chicks, before sexual maturity. And there's always one hen who will kind of mama them and look after them. And then they incorporate really seamlessly, and there's no stress on my adult hens, and it doesn't knock egg laying at all, which is really super nice. I've never had a quail chick harmed or not incorporate if I get them in between 2.5 and 3 weeks of age. It's a really, really good time. Hi, guys. And I put a bunch of sand in their brooder as well. So they've had sand to kind of dust bath in and roll around in, which is super important. That's how they keep themselves clean, is dust bathing, kind of like chickens. Nice job, guys. Okay, have a great day.